They say everybody's got a price, and now a new study in the journal Cognition proves that while babies know better than to accept nefarious gifts, they'll accept a treat from the devil himself if the offer's good enough. Here's how the study went down. Yale psychologist Kerin Wynn and psych grad student Arber Tasami introduced 5 and 8-year-olds to two characters, a nice kid and a mean kid. They both offered stickers, but while the nice kid offered a single sticker, the mean kid offered between 2 and 16 of the things. Most of the children in the study had no problem rejecting large numbers of stickers from the mean kid, except when the offer hit 16. Because 16 stickers is 16 stickers. Who cares if there's an increased wedgie risk, right? Fair enough. Those are elementary school kids, but what about babies? This is where the study really lands. The researchers conducted a similar experiment with 12 and 13-month-olds. Only instead of a nice kid, mean kid, they played nice puppet, mean puppet. We're talking a real jerk here, slamming box lids on another puppet who just wanted to fetch a cool toy out of a box, as opposed to the nice puppet who tried to help. After this little Punch and Judy show, the nice puppet offered the babies a single cracker, while the mean puppet offered two. 80% of the babies took the single cracker, because clearly this Punch character is not a cool customer. But when Punch offered 8 crackers, that's when the resolve crumbled, like the very crackers they sought to gum and litter the backseat of mom's car with. So how are we supposed to feel about all of this? I mean, on one hand, it drives home a core fact about infant cognition. Our human larvae come preloaded with the software they need to figure out this crazy, corrupt, and sometimes dangerous world. That includes logarithmic thinking and theory of mind, the ability to judge how another person or puppet is thinking. But does it also mean that humans are sellouts down to our very core? That we have an innate weakness to stranger candy, Nigerian letter schemes, and poison apples? Tasimi chooses to focus on the positive takeaway, that even 1-year-olds are willing to pay a personal cost to avoid slime balls, some regardless of the cracker-based fortune. So how do you feel about these findings? Would the child in your life take candy from a scary puppet, say the Skeksis or Lamb Chop? Let us know. And if you want more weird science wonder, drop into now.howstuffworks.com each and every day.